Okay, so today we're playing a modern MCQ, and we are playing the Red Storm. This is my list. It's pretty close to what I played in my last video. The only difference is I'm trying out two bolts for the two surgicals. I've found the surgicals to be a little bit underwhelming in the matches where I thought I wanted them, so I'm just going back to bolt. I don't actually like bolt in the meta anymore, but I couldn't think of anything else there that would have been good, so here we are playing two bolts, and I'm loving members with a creature, so we're actually already prepared for round one here on the draw. Alright, so we have one cantrip and all this gas. I'm actually okay with keeping this on the draw. On the play, I would probably mulligan. Looks like we're facing spirits. We're just gonna opt now so that way they can't get us with the curse texture spray. I can't think of the name of it. We're gonna bottom. We just gotta draw land. There we go. Ah, it's humans, okay. We have this brawl to counter the Thalia. The bolts will be a little bit better here, having them on our 75. Okay. That's pretty good. All right, so next turn we're... Oh, I can't play that, my bad. Looks like we have to pass. Reflector Mage is not just mana war. Alright, so we're going to drop number 4. It's going to leave us in a pretty precarious spot because we have to draw land to do anything. And... sure. That's for only 3 and I have a free butter. It's not looking good for us, but we need to get on the play in the next game. In general, it's really hard to win that games where they go turn one into turn one drop into Thalia into Metal Mage. It's just really hard to win those. Damn you, Metal Mage. Alright. So we did not win game one. But now we have all of this good stuff to bring in. I like cutting ops. A lot of strong players don't. My issue is I don't want to spend time cantripping. I kind of just want to already have all these bombs in my deck. So I actually like cutting one grip shot. I know that seems a little bit weird, but they're going to Metal Mage and grip shot anyway. And I think I'm okay with cutting one bear. Give this a try. screenshot. Just being our opponent. I would like to play first. This seems pretty good. So depending on what they play here, we can dismember it. Looks like a freebooter. And we're just going to allow it to resolve. And then with this ability on the stack, we're going to dismember it. Is that good enough? I think we're still short, but I'm going to give our opponent the opportunity to mess up. Or we could just be really lucky and win off of Metamorphos. What we could do is we could get a empty instead of one of the rituals, but then they just give us more force past the lanes anyway. So I'd rather just guarantee the extra mana, because I don't think getting empty in a greater does us anything. Oh, I just wanted it. There's no reason to try to not play around like for China rigor is what I'm trying to say. Okay. So that seemed to work well. Our hand is pretty good. Now we're on the draw. Probably keep it the way it is. I'm not really like noxious against humans because they apply a very fast clock and we're already keeping in or bringing in some numbers. Our opponent's mulligan again. Our hand is pretty average. I could use a removal spell. Morphos is a good pickup. I guess we're taking a brawl here. We have the natural counter to Thalia and having infinite bears. Life goal is very quickly dropping. Alright, so they're starting to run out of gas. They could still have a meddling mage or another Thalia in hand, or even a freebooter. Or an image, they could. I could go to kill it with Thalia and they could have an image. I think I just want to cast visions here. I don't want to force the upgrade. I like both of these. I'm just going to pass back. There's no need to attack. I don't want to trade my Electromancer for a blocker. You might have been asking yourself why I didn't ritual into Manamorphose last turn. We weren't likely to win off that, so it seemed like a very low ED play. And so this car alarm is going off. I don't know if the mic is picking up on that or not. And there we saw this member. So this will make everything cost 1 again. It's taking their time. I think they might have a freebooter here. They have to drip on top of her duck. We're going to pop this out. So we don't have a clean kill yet. Okay, so what we would have done there was cast their visions, drawn a random card in Scribe 2, and then play mana morphos off of the red mana, so that way we can generate blue-blue and still have available to us gifts or given or another cantrip. The reason to cast visions first is that if you control your draws, you just get a little bit more out of there, out of your cards, rather than drawing blind. So rather than two blind draws, you get one blind draw and a sculpted draw, and that is worth a lot. So it's just proper sequencing and doing everything the correct way. But hey, we won round one. Make sure to check out round two. I'm going to eat some soup in the meantime. Thanks for watching.